എല്ലാവർക്കും ബിഗ് ഫോർട്ടീൻ മീലേക്ക് സ്വാഗതം. ഇന്ന് നമ്മുടെ കൂടെയുള്ള അതിഥി കടലുകൾ താണ്ടി നമ്മുടെ കൊച്ചു ഗ്രാമം കാണാനെത്തിയ അമേരിക്കൻ സ്വദേശിയായ വെറോണിക്ക എന്ന ഒരു ടൂറിസ്റ്റ് ആണ്. വെറോണിക്കയിലേക്ക് നമുക്ക് പ്രോഗ്രാമിലേക്ക് സ്വാഗതം ചെയ്യാം. വെൽക്കം ടു അവർ ഷോ ബിഗ് ഫോർട്ടീൻ മീ. വെറോണിക്ക, മൈ ഫസ്റ്റ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ, വെരി സിമ്പിൾ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ, what comes to your mind first when you listen India?
Often what comes to my mind first is like lots of colors. I always think of Indian clothing, especially women's clothing, very colorful and beautiful.
Okay.
Ornate. And of course food is delicious. I love Indian food.
Okay, fine. Then have you been here before in India?
Yes, once before this I came about 10 or 11 years ago, and
okay.
Mainly in New Delhi in northern area. I came as part of a student group.
Oh, good. So, how did you get here? Kasaragod is a small village, especially in Kerala, in the South India, in Kasaragod, the north of Kerala. Then how did you get here?
Before I came to Kasaragod, I was in Bangalore.
Okay.
So, I came by bus, overnight bus, first to Bangalore and then took another bus down to Kasaragod.
Then what do you know about Kerala? That is the tourism about Kerala. Mm-hmm. Okay. In Kerala, what do you know about it?
I just mainly knew it was a very nice area to visit. I had some Indian friends that I knew before that suggested touring around Kerala.
Okay.
And heard just very nice, lovely beaches, nice people,
okay.
Good food.
Okay, good. Can you say about your family?
I have an older brother,
okay.
Who is an attorney, a lawyer, an older sister who works in HR.
Okay.
And a younger sister who's still a student studying to become a veterinarian, and mom and dad.
What do they do? What do your parents do?
My mom is a stay-at-home wife, and then my dad is a traffic engineer.
Uh-huh, cool. So, what was your education?
I went to university for political science, mainly studying how government works and political theory.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then, how many countries have you visited in your life?
I actually haven't counted the exact number.
Okay. How about the Asia, if I say the Asia?
In Asia, I've been to Japan, Philippines, Vietnam, Indonesia, Hong Kong, yes.
Okay.
And
so,
in South Korea.
okay, fine. Then, what do you do?
Before traveling to India, I was teaching English in South Korea.
Okay,
my contract's finished though, so I'm finished with that. When I get back to the US, I'm actually not entirely sure what I'll be doing.
Okay, cool. So when you travel, what do you want to do? Because where do you want to go? In cities or villages? What do you choose when you travel?
I do like visiting larger cities, but more often I prefer visiting smaller cities or countryside. I think that's just my preference, not only traveling but just in life. I like to visit big cities, but I prefer smaller cities or countryside. Also, when I'm traveling, I think when I visit a smaller town or more countryside, it is less number of tourists, and so it feels a little bit more authentic to me. You know, if you don't have shops that are just geared towards tourists or things geared just towards tourists, it feels a little bit more like the real India or the real country. Yeah.
Then, what do you prepare before traveling?
Mm.
Because we are traveling in India, it's a bigger country. Then what preparation did you do before coming here?
Well, since I had been in India once before, although it was in the northern part, a little bit different, I had a little bit of an idea of what to expect. But otherwise, just kind of researching what will the weather be like, and also, especially if it's the country you're going to the first time, I usually like to, especially as a woman, I like to research a little bit of the culture and customs. Like, for example, India is a little bit more conservative than the US.
Yes.
So it's good to research to know that I shouldn't just be wearing like
very
little clothes.
Yeah.
It should be a little bit more dress more appropriately for where I'm visiting.
Oh, okay.
And that's like some of those main things, like what are big cultural differences that I should be aware of to stay respectful.
Oh, okay. You have food the different food from US. If you come to India, Indian foods are very spicy.
Mm-hmm.
Then how do you manage with the food? Then how do you enjoy Indian foods?
I do like Indian food. I think I can usually eat medium or a little bit spicier, okay. So I'm okay. I know a lot of people from the US aren't very good at eating spicy
yeah.
food, but I think I'm okay. So, but even if it's something that might be too spicy for me, I usually like to at least try a little bit,
okay.
and then maybe eat some bread or naan.
Okay, then did you try in US Indian restaurant?
Yes, I have.
The spicy food.
Yes, I think most of the Indian restaurants I've tried in the US tend to be Northern Indian food.
Oh, Northern mm-hmm. food. Okay.
Then I wasn't as familiar with Southern Indian food.
Oh, okay, okay. Then the vegetarian food or non-vegetarian food?
They have both.
Both.
I eat both.
Both.
Yeah.
Well, you are here at Kasaragod. So, how many places have you visited here?
Yesterday I visited Bethel Fort and
okay.
Bethel Beach.
Uh-huh.
Those are very nice. The ocean or the sea was very beautiful.
Okay.
And then today we visited the Hanging Bridge
uh-huh.
and the Lake Temple.
Uh-huh, okay. And the lake.
Yes.
Okay. Did you see the crocodile in the lake?
We did. That was exciting.
Oh, but the crocodile is veggie, yeah. It eats only vegetarian food.
Oh really? I didn't
yeah.
know that.
Oh yeah. Okay.
So do they keep all the fish out of the lake then for him?
No. There is a priest in that uh-huh. temple. Then he gives the food.
Oh, okay.
The temple food, he gives the crocodile.
Okay. Interesting, I didn't know that. Yeah.
So how did you travel there? By taxi or public transport?
Right, to get to Bethel Fort, we took the public bus.
Okay, state bus.
Yes, exactly.
Wow, cool. Yeah, okay.
A little bit different experience.
Was it with rush or?
It was pretty crowded, but
okay.
overall it was a pretty good ride.
Okay.
I think a little bit different for me because in the US, I would often take the public transportation, the bus.
Okay.
But usually in the US, you pay, it's just one fare, no matter where you're going.
Okay.
So you just enter the bus and you pay your fare.
Okay.
Here, it's a little different because you have to tell
the place, where
you're going and they tell the price and it's a little
okay.
bit different depending
okay.
on where you go.
But therefore, for everywhere in the single price, so if mm-hmm. I travel to one place to another place, mm-hmm. the same price the bus in the
US? Yes, you're going 1 kilometer or 10 kilometers, same price.
Oh, same price. But here the price tags for the kilometer.
Yes.
Okay.
I think it's a little bit better. It's a little bit more fair.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. You said you were in South Korea.
Yes.
Yeah. What were you doing there?
I was teaching English in
uh-huh.
South Korea. I was there for about 3.5 years.
Uh-huh. In a school or university?
I was teaching at a private elementary school.
Okay. How long have you been working there?
3.5 years.
Yeah, 3 years.
Yes.
So what are the experience? Because why do they take you? Because from US, the
yes.
country is South Korea.
Yeah, they are very, they like to have native English speakers to help the students learn more conversation and speaking with, they like their students to learn the American accent often.
Okay.
So like having the native English speaker will help the students in that respect. And then I know, despite living there for 3.5 years,
yeah.
I know very little Korean because
yeah.
at the school they want the foreign teacher to speak only English
okay.
to the students.
Okay.
It's not kind of like an immersion learning experience for the students.
Do the South Korean schools, do they hire foreign faculty for any special subject? Because now you are there for English.
Mm.
Any special subject like mathematics or medicine or any other?
I'm not 100% sure, but I believe at some international schools they'll hire for other subjects as well besides English.
Okay, but normally they hire only for the
yes.
language, English
yes.
language.
I believe so.
Okay, then how is the life in South Korea? Because the last 3.5 years you were in South Korea.
Yes, I enjoyed it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a very safe country, which is very big plus. For example, if I went to a cafe, I went to a cafe to work on my computer, maybe taking a course, or I have my computer on a table and I want to use the restroom, I can leave my computer, my phone, everything
okay.
on the table,
okay.
just go, and it'll be back.
Nothing will happen.
Nothing will happen. Even 10-15 minutes I'm gone, it'll still be there.
Okay, that's nice.
Yeah, it's a very safe country, and also I know for women this is a big deal. In the US, if it's late at night, like maybe you went out with your friends drinking, you don't want to walk at night by yourself. But in Korea, perfectly safe.
In the US, you're saying that in the US, night, the woman cannot walk, yeah?
Depends on where you live, but often you don't want to.
The moral policing, you have to face it. Then who will come to you, either public or police, when you walk at night in the US?
Oh, it's just, there could be some danger if it's in a not as safe neighborhood, there might be some danger, some trying to rob you or doing something worse.
Okay, but South Korea is completely free?
Most of the time it's completely safe.
Ah, okay.
Maybe, I was living in a smaller city, not in a big city like Seoul. Maybe in some neighborhoods in Seoul that might be different, but for the most part, it's completely safe.
Oh, okay, cool.
Which was very nice.
Yeah, that's really nice. Then, have you started speaking Korean language?
Very little, unfortunately. I'm a little embarrassed by how little.
Then how do you manage the students? Because the students' mother tongue is Korean, but you don't speak Korean.
Right. So at my school I was teaching at, most of the students were actually very high level of English.
Okay.
Except for maybe starting in the first grade, some of the students wouldn't know any.
Okay.
But they got so many English lessons at my school, they picked it up very easily.
Okay.
So for the most part, I didn't have very much problems with the students in that respect. If I did have a problem, then I could maybe go to their homeroom teacher or another Korean teacher at the school for help with that.
Because maybe they don't speak English, so your other faculties for other subjects.
Right, exactly. And in public schools, I have some friends who taught English in public schools. In public schools, they would have the foreign English teacher and a Korean code teacher in the room at the same time.
Okay.
So if there was a problem that needed to be dealt with in Korean, the Korean code teacher could deal with it.
Okay. Oh, now you're in Kasago, north of Kerala. What's your plan in Kerala? Then what are the places are you going to visit? Then how long will you be here?
So I'll be in Kerala for about 10 days, 10 or 11 days. And starting in Kasaragod, and then I plan to go down to Kochi and Munnar, and maybe Alappi, and then we'll end in Trivandrum.
Okay.
Did I say it right?
Yeah, okay. Then you are leaving from here?
I'll fly from Trivandrum up to Delhi, and I'll be in Delhi for a few days.
Okay, then when are you leaving from here?
Oh, from Kasaragod?
No, from India.
Oh, from India, I'm leaving March 26th, so about 2 weeks from now, I think.
Okay, to US or are you different in the plan?
I'm planning on going to Greece.
Greece. Okay, then do you have anyone or do you, what's your plan in Greece, to see the Greece?
Yes, I'll be in Greece for maybe 3 or 4 weeks.
Okay.
And I'm traveling by myself, solo traveling.
Okay.
But I do plan on, for at least 2 of the weeks, I'll be working on a small farm on an island there.
Okay.
There's a program where you can work on the farm in exchange for room and board, so then I don't have to pay for hotel or pay for my food to be provided.
Okay. So as a self-traveler, so you travel alone, what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages when you travel you face? Especially a country like India or the Asian countries.
Right. So some advantages I think I'm a very independent person. So I like, if I feel tired, then I can just rest. Or if I do what I want. Like when I'm hungry, I go eat. I don't have to agree with someone else on what to do. So that's a nice aspect. A disadvantage is, especially in a new country you're not very used to, if you're by yourself, it's hard. If you're confused by something, you don't have someone to be like, oh, do you understand this? Or help with directions or things like that. Also, in some Asian countries, I've noticed sometimes certain foods are meant to be shared.
Okay.
So for example, in South Korea, some of the foods aren't really meant for just one person.
Okay.
So in some of the places when I would travel by myself, I couldn't actually try some of the food because they won't serve just one person. So that can be a disadvantage in some countries as
well. Because as a, did you have to face anything as a single woman traveling, while traveling?
Mm-hmm.
Any problem as a single woman?
I think you just have to be a little bit more aware of your surroundings and a little bit more careful. For example, when I traveled in the Philippines, I was in Manila by myself. I just didn't really go out at nighttime.
Okay.
So some disadvantages that way. You can't, if you're by yourself and you don't meet up with other people, you can't necessarily, sometimes you can't experience the nightlife as much.
Okay.
Just to be on the safe side.
Okay. Then, did you have any trouble with, because when you travel in India, we have, some places we have two names, because when you travel to Bengaluru, the two names, Bengaluru and Bengaluru.
Yeah.
When you travel to Mangalore, it is Mangaluru and Mangalore. So did you face any problem?
I think when I was first researching, it's just a little confusing, and I just double checking that they were indeed the same place.
Okay.
Did I really book my flight to the correct place?
Okay.
A little bit confusing. I think I've gotten a little bit used to it, but still sometimes I just need to double check if I'm booking something that is in where I think it is.
Okay. Because you're going back from Trivandrum.
Right.
But the place is also known as Thiruvananthapuram.
Yeah, I'm just going by Trivandrum because it's easier for me to say.
This is Malayalam word, Thiruvananthapuram. Yeah, but the two names.
Yes.
But you don't have to face anything from US, two double names.
Usually no.
But we have a mother tongue name and an English name.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. This is my last question. So what do you feel when you get to Kerala and Kasaragod and the people, the culture, the how do they treat you? Can you say it?
Well, for the most part, everyone has been very kind, friendly, helpful. For example, I took a overnight bus from Bangalore to Mangalore and then down to Kasaragod, but I wasn't very sure of how to get from Mangalore to Kasaragod, but there were a couple of men on the bus that were coming to Kasaragod as well, and they just helped me all along the way, show me where to get it, to catch the bus and everything, and help me. So I've had a few instances of that. It's just been very nice and refreshing where people are very friendly, helpful.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Yeah.